What's up, YouTube? Welcome to another episode of RSD Outdoors. I'm your host, Ryan. Today, I just wanted to do a quick recap for you on the tournament that I fished a few weekends ago. We fished Lake Tuckertown. Sorry, brain fart. I've been fishing those three chains of lakes a lot lately. You got Tuckertown, you got Baden Lake, and then you got Lake Tillery. I've been fishing with the Archdale Bass Club this year, in between me coaching baseball, but that's another story. But today I just wanted to give you a little recap on my game plan going in and how it actually turned out and panned out for me. This past tournament I finished 10th. There was about 25 people that entered that one, so I was in the middle of the pack. I did get to pre-fish it. I pre-fished it. It was right around the spawn. It was a full moon. A lot of people, I got word that a lot of people were catching on beds. Me and my partner, we saw a few beds, but really not many, so we kind of had to switch things up and we went with a reaction bait the whole day. That was really how we got most of the results. Let's see. It was a real big cold front that came in that night. So I'll show you some of the pictures here. First 10 minutes out there, my partner Eddie, he catches a 6-pounder. That was a beaut. I'm like, whoa, he didn't even give me time to warm up this time. But so yeah, Eddie catches that 6-pounder, and then I catch a 3-pounder right in the same cove, maybe 20 yards on down the bank. He caught his on a buzz bait, and I caught mine on a chatter bait. I was throwing my Enigma 7-foot medium action. Just got plenty of tip, and I'm throwing it on 15-pound fluorocarbon. And my bait of choice was the jackhammer. And I was throwing the Yamamoto trailer on the back of that. No trailer hook. That lake, I don't know if many of y'all have visited, but that lake's full of grass. That was my reason for throwing that chatterbait. Chatterbait is a great bait for fishing grass lakes. That lake's full of submerged grass, so maybe 3-4 foot deep. It's plenty of snot grass. You can barely get a good cast in without getting hung up on something, so that was my reason for that. Rewind, another thing we had to deal with that morning was fog. You couldn't even see 20 feet in front of the boat. Luckily, we were able to get to a pocket that was close to the boat ramp that we chose to leave from that day. You know, that paid off. We got off to a quick start. We caught two other fish in that creek arm, and I caught all mine on the chatterbait. He caught a few more on the buzzbait. We moved around some more that day, and everything else, like I said, was a reaction. The bite slowed down. He got a few more bites on the buzzbait, but not as much once that sun started to poke up. He started to catch more on the chatterbait. I kind of put the chatterbait down, and I wanted to, one, fish something different from him, two, fish something a little more subtle, because I fished for a while on the bottom. I knew they were supposed to be spawning, so I tried to fish it a little bit of hard cover with some sinking baits. I threw a jig, I threw shaky head, wacky worm, I threw drop shot, I threw Texas rig. They didn't want it, so I went back to reaction, but I went more subtle. This has been a killer for me. I was throwing this swim bait on an eighth ounce, and throwing that on a 17-pound test. Now, like I said, that grass is, you know, very shallow, so it was important for me to use that 17-pound line to keep the bait up high in the water column so the fish could see it. It's been chewed up. But you can see it's just a Strike King caffeine shad in a white and blue pearl with an 1/8 ounce young swim bait head. Like I said, that bait was actually the key for me in the tournament. I didn't tell you which ride I was throwing it on. It's actually one of my favorite all-around rides. It's a 7.3 medium heavy. It's good for buzz baits, horny toes, jigs, cinco's, spinner baits. It can handle anything from a fourth of an ounce all the way up to an ounce, but it's a really good ride. It's probably my favorite all-purpose ride. It can handle anything you want to do with it. Really, that was it. I couldn't get bit on anything else that day. That bait and the chatterbait, it did it for me. So going in, dropping a rod. But going into the tournament, you know, it was 2 weeks later. We had nothing but sunlight after that. So like I said, that day was a cold front. So you're like, I know the fish have changed since then, coming off the spawn, and a lot warmer since the pre-fishing that I did. Like I said, it was a 2 week gap, so I knew I better throw something top water, so I started off with buzz bait, actually me and my partner, and hit a few areas and really nothing. I threw the chatter bait a lot because I knew that was getting bit. Couldn't get bit on it. Fished and fished. Finally, maybe the third stop we went to, cast it out in front of a little point that had some grass in front of it and caught a nine keeper, and I'll show you guys that real quick. And fished on, and finally caught, I'll show you guys, this will be a 4.5 pounder, right under 5 pounds, the only keeper fish I caught that day. Skipped it up under a tree limb, and I'm guessing that bass was on a bed, and she smacked it. I didn't even get to engage the reel. She was on it, and she choked it. So I knew I had the right bait selection, but really just couldn't get any more to hit it. I had one chase the chatterbait right before that, so that's why I decided to slow down and throw the swim bait. But I was also, like I said, I was throwing that top water after that because it stayed pretty cloudy that day. So I was throwing my HPT rod in a 7.3 medium heavy, which is the same as the Phenom that I just told you about, but a higher end model. And I was throwing that one on 50 pound braid with my Quantum reel, high speed, 7.3:1. And I got a swim bait on. That was just a last minute adjustment. I tried to make around some grass, but I couldn't get any takers. We got over 20 strikes on top water between buzz baits and frogs, but they were just pushing the bait. You know, they come up behind it, some you saw chase it, and some just came up and snipped at it, but they would just push it, they wouldn't eat it. So it was a frustrating day, to say the least, like just seeing that many fish come up and make a fool of you, I guess. It ain't like we were jerking on them too early. They, you know, we would wait, use the 2 or 3 second counting technique, or me, I just wait till I feel it most of the time when I'm fishing top water. They just wouldn't eat it. The winning weight for that tournament was about 15 pounds. Big fish went 6 pounds, so I was close, but, you know, it happens. Just still trying to get my feet wet. I hadn't fished tournaments in probably 3 or 4 years, so it's good to get back out there and having a lot of time, having a lot of fun with those guys. Maybe if I'd have wore my lucky fishing shirt, maybe that would have made a little difference, but we'll see what happens from here. I'll show you guys a quick picture of the keeper fish that I did catch, and I'll be coming out with some more videos soon. I just wanted to touch base with you guys. If you got any more questions about Lake Tuckertown or just anything, the rides, like I said, I'm a pro staff member and authorized dealer, so I'm able to sell them to you guys. Love to help you out with them. I got a whole corner full of them. I'll do a ride review for you guys soon, but look for me soon. I got a few more videos coming out, and can't wait to talk to you guys. In the meantime, cast, catch, repeat, and we'll talk to you soon.